him with their children. Also tonight, Hillary Clinton speaking on television for the first time since the Weinstein scandal broke. She had been silent on the sexual harassment accusations against Weinstein, a major Democratic donor and someone she called a friend until yesterday, 5 days after the allegations surfaced. Here she is tonight speaking to our Fareed Zakaria about her reaction when she first heard the Weinstein news.
I was just sick. I was shocked. I was appalled. It was something that was just intolerable in every way. And, you know, like so many people who have come forward and spoken out, this was a different side of a person who I and many others had known in the past.
Would you have called him a friend?
Yes, I probably would have. And so would so many others. You know, people in Democratic politics for a couple of decades appreciated his help and support. And I think these stories coming to light now and people who never spoke out before having the courage to speak out just clearly demonstrates that this behavior that he engaged in cannot be tolerated.
All right, a lot more of what she had to say ahead, because there is a lot more. We begin, though, with Stephanie Elam in Los Angeles tonight. And Stephanie, what do you know about this 911 call?
Well, what we understand happened, Aaron, is that Los Angeles Police Department officers responded to the house of the daughter of Harvey Weinstein at about 10:37 a.m. They're not giving out a lot of details. They're saying that they are currently investigating, but obviously this is noteworthy considering all of the turmoil around this man, all of the accusations that are coming out about him, but very little information on why that happened, who was there, and what may have happened that would lead his daughter or someone from the house to make that call, Aaron.
All right. Thank you very much, Stephanie. As we try to figure out the nature of this, let's go now to our senior political analyst, Mark Preston, sex crimes prosecutor, Stacey Honowitz, and our senior media correspondent, Brian Stelter. Brian, let me start with you and what you're hearing about Weinstein tonight.
Certainly in recent days, Weinstein's friends have been worried about him. You know, he traveled in a very elite group of media CEOs, Hollywood big shots, people like that. I spoke with a CEO of a major media company earlier in the week who said, I am concerned about Harvey. I'm concerned that he's going to lash out in the wrong way, that he's not going to take the right lessons from this ordeal. You know, earlier in the week, Aaron, Weinstein was blaming his brother Bob, saying this was all Bob's plot to force me out of the company. Now, as of last night, Weinstein's representative said he is on the way to rehab. There were reports he might be flying to Europe for rehab.
Right.
As of right now, though, he's still in Los Angeles. He said to Page Six, I am going to go to rehab. I don't know where I'm going to do it yet. I'm doing therapy. This sounds like a man that is at war with himself. Yeah. And has his friends concerned.
And as you say, still in L.A., we don't know the nature of that 911 call, whether it was related to him or his state at this time. Mark Preston, what do you make of Hillary Clinton coming out? And look, she had not said anything for 5 days, had given a 90-minute talk in which she talked about sexism and misogyny, and she didn't bring it up. She then put out a statement, but these are her first comments that we are hearing in depth, and there's a lot more we're going to play in a moment, but in depth, you heard her say how she felt when she heard this about a person that she called a friend.
Yeah, right. You know, so a couple things. One is, as you pointed out last night, Aaron, it took her 5 days to put a statement out. Now, you got to give someone the benefit of the doubt, maybe give them a day or two after the New York Times story breaks just to see if there's any truth to it. However, to wait 5 days to put a statement out and then to wait a sixth day to actually go on camera and address it, especially since that was a major plank of your campaign, the empowerment of women, specifically young women in the workplace and in advancement and breaking the glass ceiling. So that is where she failed, as did President Barack Obama. I had a Republican call me today, somebody who, you know, folks would see as very centrist thinking, and said, you know what? You know what I'm really frustrated about? I'm frustrated about that if this had been a Republican, the media would have gone after them a lot harder.
The media went after Hillary Clinton and Barack Obama plenty hard for the past few days. And aren't we holding them to a much higher standard than the president of the United States? I mean, Hillary Clinton's now said a lot more than Donald Trump has about this.
But Brian, but what we're doing right now is we're comparing apples and oranges. We can talk about Donald Trump. We can talk about the Hollywood access tape. We can talk about the Republican Party. We can talk about that any other day. At the moment, though, we're talking about somebody whose campaign was based upon the empowerment of women, and to wait that long is really absurd. And I will say this, the Republican did say, that we had done a good job, but overall, I do agree with him, that there wasn't as much made out of this if it had not been if it had been a Republican instead.
So Stacey, let me just play here another part of the conversation, the exchange between Fareed and Hillary Clinton, when Fareed asked her whether people knew. And again, the context here for everyone watching is Hillary Clinton called Harvey Weinstein a friend. She did today. She said he had been a friend, right? So that is very clear. Yeah. And someone who had been a major donor to her presidential campaign, to her Senate campaign, and to Democrats everywhere, and a Democratic liberal activist. So Fareed asked whether people knew, and here's how she responded.
Well, I certainly didn't, and I don't know who did, but I can only speak for myself, and I think speak for many others who knew him primarily through politics. But the courage of these women coming forward now is really important, because it can't just end with one person's disgraceful behavior and the consequences that he is now facing. This has to be a wake-up call and shine a bright spotlight on anything like this behavior anywhere at any time.
Of course, Stacey, that's the right thing to say and the important thing to say. Obviously, yes, it would have been great if she had said that days ago, but that is the right thing to say.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I don't really think this is a partisan issue. I mean, when you're somebody that's facing sexual assault charges and all these things are in your background, I don't think you can expect your friends to know that's going on. You know, you always hear those stories where a rabbi or a priest or the man down the street that you thought was so nice turns out that he's, you know, committing sexual crimes among kids. And the first thing you say is, oh, my God, I would have never thought. And I think that's what you're finding here. I don't think that the real close friends of his, I mean, other than in the circles of him hearing that he was a creep, I don't think they knew that he was doing this to all these women. And I think that's what she's trying to say. I don't know about her timing. I don't know why she waited. She does have a platform of empowering people, but she's doing what she has to do now, and that is to talk about that she did not know, and that what he is doing is abominable, and she's not going to stand for it, and nobody else should stand for it.
So that's another thing that she said was actually about the money, right? And as everyone knows, plenty of Democrats, in fact, you know, Democrat after Democrat, from Kirsten Gillibrand, Richard Blumenthal, on and on, have said they're going to return the money, and if not return it, they're going to donate it. I mean, basically, they're all saying they're going to donate it to worthy women's causes. Here's what she said when Fareed asked about that.
Senator Blumenthal says that people should give back the money that he donated to them. He donated money to you directly and indirectly. Mm-hmm. Would you give the money back?
Well, there's no one to give it back to. What other people are saying, what my former colleagues are saying, is they're going to donate it to charity. And of course I will do that. I give 10% of my income to charity every year. This will be part of that. There's no doubt about it.
Mark?
Well, 10% plus, right? Or is that going to be 10% thereof? Here is the issue, though, for Democrats, right? The bottom line is Hillary Clinton, other Democrats, was on the receiving end of a large amount of money from Harvey Weinstein, as well as those people who had supported him and had backed him, and he would hold fundraisers. So it's not just the amount of money that came out of his pocket. It was the people that would show up at the fundraisers that he would hold. The problem, though, becomes is that you always have to answer for the misdeeds of others. And in this case, Democrats happen to be on the short stick of this one, and they have to pony up and address it. Look, you see the body language right there. She didn't really seem to want to address that, but she had to.
No, and that's what's interesting about it, Brian. Yeah. She didn't really want to address it.
Right.
For someone who
this interview was not scheduled about Weinstein. It was scheduled well ahead of time about other topics.
Right. But she certainly knew this was going to come up.
That's right.
I mean, she knew this was going to be a crucial part of it.
Yeah.
And she didn't want to, at least on that part, really delve into it, which again just raises the question.
Yeah.
I mean, she wants to be, and she is, for so many women, the leader of women's causes and women's rights in this country.
In some ways, she and Barack Obama serve as sort of alternative fantasy presidents. You know, you look at the way they react when Trump says things that are irresponsible or disturbing. They weigh in right away on Twitter and Facebook. They jump at the opportunity to serve as that kind of president in waiting almost, even though neither of them are ever going to run again. I think, is it too much to ask for consistency of outrage? That's what this is about, right? Whether it's a Democrat or a Republican, when these stories happen, when these scandals break, I think what most Americans want is just consistency of outrage.
Consistency of outrage.
Well, there's such a sense of embarrassment on anyone's part that had a relationship with him.
Right.
Because they're going to look at people and say, oh, my God, how could I be friendly with this person? And so I think they feel the same way. I mean, Obama's daughter was an intern for the Weinstein Company. Do you think if he knew that this was going on, he would have allowed his daughter to go work at that company? So everybody is feeling this feeling. What do I do now? Now I'm caught. Well, I was friendly with this guy. Let me give back. Let me step up. Let me do the right thing. That's the kind of framework that we're in right now.
Right. And of course, Mark, the big question is, what's to happen to stop it from happening again? I mean, I think we all know eventually this story will happen again and there'll just be another name. Right. I mean, we've seen it with Roger Ailes. Right. We've seen it with Bill O'Reilly. We've seen it now with Harvey Weinstein. And of course, we saw it with Donald Trump.
You know, unfortunately, what we're seeing right now in the last 24, 48, 72 hours is that women do feel like they can come out and speak because they feel like there's a level of protection around them. And then all of us are rallying around them. But what happens in the news environment is people soon forget. And this is one of those instances that you hope now, 5 days from now, 5 weeks from now, 5 years from now, that we don't recycle this and have to go through all these steps again, that our memories are a little bit longer than perhaps what they usually are.
You will.
Thank you all very much. And next, President Trump selling his tax plan as a middle-class miracle. It is a miracle, and we'll show you how. Leaving him with their children. Also tonight, Hillary Clinton speaking on television for the first time since the Weinstein scandal broke. She had been silent on the sexual harassment accusations against Weinstein, a major Democratic donor and someone she called a friend until yesterday, 5 days after the allegations surfaced. Here she is tonight speaking to our Fareed Zakaria about her reaction when she first heard the Weinstein news.
I was just sick. I was in, cannot be tolerated.
All right, a lot more of what she had to say ahead, because there is a lot more. We begin, though, with Stephanie Elam in Los Angeles tonight. And Stephanie, what do you know about this 911 call?
Well, what we understand happened, Aaron, is that Los Angeles Police Department officers responded to the house of the daughter of Harvey Weinstein at about 10:37 a.m. They're not giving out a lot of...
Shocked. I was appalled. It was something that was just intolerable in every way. And, you know, like so many people who have come forward and spoken out, this was a different side of a person who I and many others had known in the past.
Would you have called him a friend?
Yeah. Details. They're saying that they are currently investigating, but obviously this is noteworthy considering all of the turmoil around this man, all of the accusations that are coming out about him, but very little information on why that happened, who was there, and what may have happened that would lead his daughter or someone from the house to make that call, Aaron.
All right. Thank you very much, Stephanie. As we try to figure out the nature of this, let's go now to our senior political analyst, Mark Preston, sex crimes prosecutor Stacey Hanna.
Yes, I probably would have. And so would so many others. You know, people in Democratic politics for a couple of decades appreciated his help and support. And I think these stories coming to light now and people who never spoke out before having the courage to speak out just clearly demonstrates that this behavior that he engaged